Why, everybody, and welcome back to video number two in our Gradebook series. We are looking at 2.5 version of Moodle here at Humboldt State University. And when we last left our heroes, we were inside the categories and items in the Video Base 2 Gradebook. And by golly, here we are again. Categories and items. We are in the simple view, as it says at the top of the page. There is a full view. Let's give that a click, kind of giving you a tour of some of the utilities. Notice new things appear on the right-hand side of the screen. Aggregate including subcategories. Never use this. Drop the lowest, keep the highest, multiplicator, and offset. We're going to talk more about those in detail in other videos. I would recommend, if you're going to drop the lowest, that you do this later in the semester because of the way grades are put together. We'll explain more in later videos. I'm going to select Simple View. There are three grade methods here at HSU, and we'll have a video on each of those. This section is to primarily deal with adding categories. Even if you're going to use the most rudimentary grade book, where you have a list of items, you total the points up, they total 500 points, so-and-so gets 450, they get a grade, you're done. I recommend categories. It helps keep things clear. Think of this area you see here where it says Video Base 2 as the house. Each category is a room which we can then fill with contents. We do have a sample assignment created already, so I'm going to add a category to put that content in. All you really need to do here, I'm going to call this assignments, and I have determined that my assignments are worth 30% of the grade. Everything else I'm going to leave alone, and in the category total, I'm not going to fill that in here. There are more convenient and effective ways to make changes than in the category total, so ignore it. All I've done is type assignments, 30%, and I'm going back to the front page. Okay, there's my first category. If I want to put an assignment, which I've created on the front page, into that category, I come all the way to the right-hand side where it says Select, and there's a little box. And I'm going to check in the box, then I'm going to come to the bottom of the page where it says Move Items To, and choose Assignments. And it happens automatically. Now, unlike putting grades in the grader view, this is not automatic. I strongly recommend saving your change after completing a task. Select Save Changes, and you are ready to go. So adding a category, select the button, add the content to the category name. I'm going to call this Research. That's going to be worth 30% of my grade, and I'm going to choose Save Changes. Now, this actually has no mathematical value. To make this really worth 30% of the grade, you need to, in fact, do another couple of steps, and we'll show you that in the weighted, simple weighted means section. Categories are very simple. Now, adding a grade item, right next to add a category at the bottom, we have add a grade item. Well, this will add you an item, and I'm going to call this writing 2. Grade type, value. The maximum they can get is 100. The grade category is going to go into assignments to save my changes. And there I have created a grade item. Notice writing 2, when we come all the way to the right-hand side of the page, you can delete it from right here. Notice you cannot do that from the sample assignment. That's because the sample assignment was created on the front page, and there are some values to this. Let's go to the front page. Let's select Video 2 and our breadcrumbs. That'll return us to the front page. Let's scroll down and let's look in the right-hand column in Activities, and notice there is an entry for Assignments. Let's select Assignments. Okay, the sample assignment is there, but Writing 2 is not. That's your first clue. Let's select Sample Assignments, which is highlighted, and here is why putting assignments from the front page is so valuable. You have the information at the top, which is going to clarify the assignment criteria for your students. in the middle of the page, about in the middle of the screen, it says view and grade all submissions. And here you have the opportunity to grade your students all in one spot, and even in the right-hand column, add feedback. Notice feedback is, again, a place where you can type in up to 150 characters. If there's 151, things will be fine, but don't stick an entire paper in there. You're going to freeze your class like Han Solo in carbonite. It's also important at the bottom, it says save all changes. Please do that. That information will go directly into the gradebook. And notice in options, you can choose the number of assignments per page and a filter. So if you've been doing some grading, you can choose the requires grading option, and then anything that is still ungraded will stand out for you. Big thing here, save all the quick grading changes. I'm going to go back to video 2 on my front page. I'm going to go back into the gradebook. And a reminder, when you create in categories and items, let's select that. When we go to the bottom and when we add a grade item, there is no interaction on the front page. You must go to the gradebook view to put in a value for that item. Come back next video and we're going to go into detail on each of the methods of grading and how to set those up once you have created your category from the information in your syllabus. Thank you.